Hi there, quick little video on what's known as the Alpine Butterfly, sometimes called the Butterfly Loop or the Lineman Loop, depending on whether or not you read Clifford Ashley's Book of Knots. This is a very useful knot in load-bearing situations where your rope is vertical, anchored at the top, a load on the bottom, possibly you being that load. And there are a couple good applications for this, but one I want to talk about today, and a way of tying it I have not seen yet on any YouTube video. I thought it was a little simpler for me, and I thought I would share that with everybody else. First of all, though, before we get into this, breaking strength versus working strength. Ropes are tested according to ASTM standards under laboratory conditions when they are new, and they look for what is the lowest load, tensile load, at which that's going to break. And that is what's called the minimum breaking strength, your MBS. Safe working load, SWL, typically is a fifth of that. That's because over time, the materials will degrade and the knot will be, or the rope will become weaker. Also, knots weaken rope. Most people aren't aware of that fact. And knots are rated by their efficiency or their knot strength, which is what percentage of the minimum breaking strength is left. That comes from testing ropes with knots in them. And what they've discovered is that the rope typically breaks at or just near the knot itself. Because with the knot, the rope is pinching on itself and breaking down the fibers, and that's where it goes. So we like to use knots that are very efficient, those that have the closest strength rating to the original minimum breaking strength of the rope itself. Hence, we get into safe working load being 15 to 25% of the minimum breaking strength, because some knots are pretty inefficient, below 50%. You're cutting, you know, that minimum breaking strength down in half. And it'll pop at half that at the knot, and not to mention that if it's an older rope, it's going to be degraded even more. So we have to be careful about those kinds of things. So here is an easy way to tie the Alpine Butterfly. You literally screw the knot together. Now here's how I like to do it. Lay the rope over your wrist, or put your wrist up against it if it's vertical, and we're going to screw this knot together. We're going to grab it and we're going to rotate it. I'm going to move the camera down here a bit so I can get a better angle. We're going to rotate it in the same direction two times. We are going to twist it 180 degrees, lay it over the thumb. We're then going to take the part between the thumb and the finger, twist it 180 degrees, and lay it over the finger. And if you look, this is what we've got. We've got that rope now, just like that, with a cross below the thumb. I'm going to put the tip of the thumb and the tip of the finger together and roll this loop back. Then I'm going to stuff it under that cross like this. And I basically have made my Alpine Butterfly. I'm going to cinch it up a little bit vertically, and then to set the knot, give it a tug this way. And when you do, the knot is set and hopefully well dressed. Now the advantage of this knot is that you can have a load on the line, on the standing line like this, and that loop is not load bearing. That loop is loose, it will not collapse, it will not cinch up. You can use this for putting on a third pull. You can put a carabiner on that with another line and use that as a tagline to pull this out. You can tie something else onto that, tools for hauling or whatever. But once you tie that, this is strong. Now the efficiency of the Alpine Butterfly is about 65%, meaning whatever the minimum breaking strength of that rope is, you've just lopped off 35% with this knot. Believe it or not, that's good for this type of a knot. Remember that safe working load, that SWL. About a fifth of the minimum breaking strength. Now, here's one of the real advantages of this knot right here. And this would come in handy in an emergency or a survival type situation where you've got a rope in your truck, you've got it in your kit, And you notice, now you're not going to do this to your rope, I'm going to do this just for purpose of the demonstration. By the way, Crash Blade, thank you, Crash. Imagine that you dug out your rope and you opened it up and you saw, holy cow, what the heck happened to my rope here? My rope is degraded, my rope is worn, my rope is frayed, my rope has half the fibers cut in it. Here's a way you can salvage nearly the full length of that rope. You tie the Alpine Butterfly. You take the worn part and you lay that over your wrist. You screw it or twist it, one turn to the right over the thumb, one turn to the left over the finger. Put the thumb and the finger together, grab that frayed part, bring it back and tuck it under that X and right up along your thumb. Then you pull the knot like this, then you set it along the line like this, and all of a sudden, I now have regained 65% of the strength of my rope, the breaking strength of the rope. By doing this, I've isolated that bad spot in the rope. It's still perfectly straight, still good and strong. I can tie it quickly, and in an emergency situation, I am good to go. So I hope that was a fairly simple and easy way to tie the knot for y'all. I looked all over YouTube, couldn't see anyone else that did it that way. And not too many people discuss using this knot as a way to isolate a bad weak spot in the rope. Hope that's helpful. See y'all later. Have a good night.